إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ Certainly he is the ultimate authority, the one who always shows love and mercy. إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُّومُ Now that Allah mentions His mercy, out of His mercy also, this is part of our belief too, out of His mercy He describes hellfire. It's out of His mercy that He describes hellfire. Why? It's the scared straight program in the Quran. The idea that hell is not just described as a place that's bad, it's very graphic. It's laid out. And because the Arabic language is so picturesque, and it's got so much imagery in it, you can visualize some crazy things that are being described. So and the point of it is to terrify you, so you get your act together. If hellfire wasn't described in such depth and such graphic language, then you know what? Why take it seriously? How bad could it be? I've brought this up to you guys before. What's the concept of hell in modern entertainment? What has it become? It's a joke. People wear jackets that say highway to hell. Flaming skulls. You know, cartoons are made of people from hell. Action figures, superheroes that come from hell. Or people journeying into hell and coming right back out. Like it's, you know, like a prison, you can break in and break out. It's no big deal. It's become a joke. It's become a thing to just, you know, entertain yourself with. It makes for fun horror stories. This is a reality. Inna shajarata zakum, the tree of zakum, that's the proper name of it. It's one of the trees of hellfire. Ta'amul athim, it is the food of the one constantly engrossed in sin. Athim. Kal muhli, it's like boiling hot water. Muhl. And muhl is also used for blood. Yaghli fil butun, it, you know how when you take oil and you put it on a pan that's already hot, it makes that sound. I don't have a word for it. Ulumi kate kholna. The sizzling sound. That's ghala yaghli. It sizzles in the belly. It gets into the belly and then it starts sizzling. Kaghalyil hamim, like the scorching and the sizzling of boiling water when it reaches its top. Khudhuhu fa'tiluhu ila sawa'il jahim. Grab him and shove him inside the deep, very middle of the hellfire, of the roaring flame. ثُمَّ صُبُّ فَوْقَ رَأْسِهِ Then pour above his head. Now there's torture going on inside of him. Internally he's sizzling. On top of him, مِنْ عَذَابِ الْحَمِيمِ From the punishment of boiling hot water. ذُقْ Taste this. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْكَرِيمِ You're the one, right? You're the one that has the ultimate authority, the noble. The noble of the pharaohs were drowned, remember? One of the great reasons that the people of Mecca didn't accept the Prophet's message, Allah describes them as too drunk on their own grace, you know, status. Mutrafin. So Allah says, here's what your nobility's worth. Taste it. This is what it was. Inna hadha ma kuntum bihi tamtarun. This is the very thing you used to be in doubt about. Inna al-muttaqina fi maqamin amin. No doubt about it. Those who sought to protect themselves, the righteous, are going to be in a safe place. فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونٍ In gardens, in grapevines surrounding them. يَلْبَسُونَ مِنْ سُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ They're going to be dressing in sundus and istabraq, light silk and heavy silk. Light silk and heavy, two different kinds of garments. مُتَقَابِلِينَ Meeting one another. So once they get dressed up, first you get dressed up, you pick your outfit or whatever, then you go hang out with other people in paradise. You're like, hey, what are you doing here? This is mutaqabil, facing one another. متقابلين. كذلك زوجناهم بحور عين. That is how we reward, and we will also have married them off to حور, beautiful spouses. عين, whose eyes are, what's the word? Hypnotic. Whose eyes are حور. عين is called when the white of your eyes is really white and the dark of your eyes is really dark. The contrast in your eyes just is captivating. This is حور عين. يَدْعُونَ فِيهَا بِكُلِّ فَاكِهَةٍ آمِنِينَ They're going to be calling in it all kinds of fruits, sitting peacefully, relaxed, and they're just ordering food. Like, hey, what do you want to eat? Let's have that fruit we had. And then they taste it, and we talked about the taste before. So they're chilling in Jannah. لَا يَذُوقُونَ فِيهَا الْمَوْتِ They're not going to be tasting death in it. إِلَّا الْمَوْتَةَ الْأُولَى Except the first death. This is actually a sarcasm in the Qur'an. You know, the disbeliever said, we're not going to have death except the first death. Allah says, yeah, first death, that's only for those people. They're only going to be able to say, that first death we already tasted is the only one we're going to taste. And by the way, for the person in hellfire, you could argue, well, they're not going to taste death either. Yes, they are. لَا يَمُوتُ فِيهَا وَلَا Yahya. لا تدعوا اليوم ثبورا وادعوا ثبورا كثيرا. Allah says, don't ask for death today, ask for death over and over again. You will experience the tortures of death one after the other, continually. That's ثبور in Arabic. So on the one hand, there's no death at all, and the other is continual death, one after the other. وَوَقَاهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ And He had protected them from the punishment of the roaring flame. فَضْلًا مِّن رَبِّكَ This is out of a great favor from your master. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمِ That, in fact, is the ultimate success. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ is not complicated. I swear by the passage of time, and time itself is proof that all of humanity is drowning in loss. It's not complicated, it's straightforward. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ So they can just try to remember. They can try to take the advice. And for Muslims, there's another added benefit. Allah says, we made it easy on your tongue so that they can make an effort to memorize. It's another meaning of يَتَذَكَّرُونَ here. So they can memorize Qur'an easily. You get started, you'll be shocked how easy it is. You just never thought about it. You just never thought you could do it. Just do it. Just try one ayah, two ayah a day. Just get started.
But I don't have a teacher. I don't know. My tajweed isn't perfect.
Stop making excuses. Just do it. Just start memorizing. Work on your tajweed. I'm not saying to work on it. Work on your Arabic, that's fine. But memorize Quran. Make that a part of your life. And the days that you memorize Quran, you'll notice a barakah in your day that you don't notice in days you didn't memorize Quran. You'll testify that yourself. I just want to relax. So Allah says, these are the gardens, not just of constant activity, but they're also of constant relaxation. Na'im. Sitting back. Softness. Luxury. عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ On beds and lofty, high beds and couches, they're going to be facing one another. So there are now gardens, and there's a huge, gigantic living room, and you're sitting in the living room, and you can see everybody. But Allah will make it so we get to see everybody, everybody gets to see everybody else. Hey, you're here? Yeah. Oh, I didn't think you'd... Okay, well, you know, welcome. That's awesome to have you here too. How's it been? So when'd you get here? Well, you know, I died when I was 82. I died when I was 40. Subhanallah. And then this guy in the back, he goes, I've been here since like the 3rd century, because I was a shaheed. And we're like, tell us your story. And we're just, everybody's facing everybody, they're talking. And of course, if you're hanging out together and talking, there needs to be some drinks. So, and since they're sitting on couches already, they shouldn't get up and get the drinks. Hold on, I'm a little thirsty. Give me a minute, you want to get something? No. You all sit, relax. Yutafu alayhim. Tawaf will be done all over them. Meaning there are servants that are constantly running around with drinks. Min bika'sin, with cups, min ma'in, of clear crystal. And drink that is clear, you can see right through it. Sir, more drink? Ma'am, more drink? And there's passing out. Everybody's getting drinks. You know? And these servants are coming, you don't even have to get up. Bayda'a, and the drinks are clear white, some of them. Ladhatin lisharibin. Bayda'a ladhatin, white in taste. Meaning you can taste the color. You see the color, looks good. Oh, it tastes awesome too. Because you know what happens? Sometimes the color looks good in dunya, of a drink. When you taste it, you're like, patu, what is that? You know, like me, for example, I can't stand ruabza. I can't stand it. But I love strawberry milk. So first time I saw ruabza, it's like, oh, I'm going to down this sucker. So you go halfway down the glass and you're like, ah, what is this? You know? But this is now the color of it. Looks enticing, but you're still kind of scared. And then you're like, I don't know if it's going to be... Let me try a little. No, you have the rest, Mom. You drink the rest. This is yutafu. Bayda'a, crisp, very clear white. White of texture implies, white of taste implies, the taste is going to be pure. It's going to be fresh. Lishadibin. For people that are going to be continually drinking. And it's not like you're full. When the guy comes back and you're like, no, I had enough. Any more, my bladder will explode.